Hello, my name is Abel Abelson. I'm the writer of a few books that will probably interest you if you came to this video. See the links in the description. And today I'd like to talk about everyday parental toxicity. Now, we all know that there are extremely toxic parents. Parents can be extremely toxic in very spectacular ways. I mean sexual abuse, physical abuse, stuff like that. But there is also a kind of everyday parental toxicity that is so widely spread and is of a kind of low intensity, but in its continuous presence has an enormous devastating effect on the psychology and personality of children from childhood into adulthood, etc. That it's really important to talk about that too. So what I'd like to talk about today is an extremely regular way of nullifying children and their personality and their existence that could be described as you are nobody unless, and then whatever. You are nobody unless you are a famous scientist, unless you are a famous artist, unless you can remember all the states of the United States, unless you are very good at mathematics, unless you are extremely nice and compassionate, unless whatever. It can be whatever. It can appear something good that they're trying to impose on you, to push you into, but the fact is that the mere psychological setting, the mere mental surrounding of people that continuously make you feel you are nobody unless is really nullifying you. It's actually saying that there are conditions to be met before you really exist. Now, this isn't true. You are there the way you are. You exist anyway. It's not dependent on conditions. So if they make you feel you're not really someone unless some conditions are met, it's really like killing you. It's really like not letting you being born, like not letting you exist in this world. Now, one has to pay very good attention. Obviously, it's very rare for parents or people to literally say this to you. They won't literally say to you, you're nobody because you don't meet certain criteria. They'll make it feel all the time. And I can speak of personal experience in this. Now, I'm sure if my parents would see this, hello, mom and dad, that they completely would not agree that they had this toxic effect on me. They would maintain that they had the best intentions for me, and I believe that they believe so. However, they are wrong. Now, it's not their fault, it's the fault of their parents and their parents and their parents, etc., etc. I don't blame anyone in particular. I don't blame anyone personally. But it's extremely important as a child, as a person living the effect of this toxic situation, to know that it's a reality and that it's a toxic reality. So how do parents pass on this message of you are nobody unless? For instance, you come back from school and you have your grades. Now, here in Europe, we don't use A, B, C, etc. We use from 0 to 10. Now, they look at your grades and they say, oh, that's so great. A 10, a 10, a 9, a 7. A 7 is not so good, but it's okay. Next time better. And a 10 and a 9. Very good. You did very well. Now, at first sight, this looks like something very supportive. This looks like a loving parent that's giving support to his child. I don't agree. I really don't agree. What I think is real support to this real existing being, this real existing child with all its emotional, mental, psychological realities, would be, how is life for you? How did your day go in this school where we send you every day, where you have to go, where you mix with other people. How is it? How is this thing going for you? How do you feel? And then as a kid, you could say, well, some things are okay, but other things are really shit, and I don't know. And it could be a whole discussion between really existing people. And the fact that they just look at your grades is, as such, nullifying the complete rest of your existence, which is like 99.99% of your existence is not in those grades. Those grades do not represent your existence. They don't even represent in a very significant way your personality, the way you are in life, whether you're depressed or not. It doesn't even represent that. You can feel like shit and have 10 in 10 points. That's no problem. I know, because I did it. So that's one way, one example of how this setting of you don't exist unless, in this case, unless you have good grades is passed on. Another example is, and I speak again of personal experience, is when you go about your life and then your parents will say, look at this person, this is really someone. And that would be then like a great politician or a great artist or some celebrity. For a kid like me, I was intelligent and sensitive enough to understand that this means that if I don't meet the kind of conditions that those people met, that I would not be someone in their eyes. And I don't take it personally now. I think they look at themselves in the same way, and people have looked on them in the same way, but this doesn't take away that it's toxic, that it's eating you away from the inside as a kid and later on as an adult, etc. So my message here is, one, be conscious of this kind of toxic influence. The second thing I'd like to pass on in this video is, don't let yourself be nullified. I mean, and by this I don't mean get into conflict with those people. I don't mean try to explain them that it's toxic. You can, but the chance of getting somewhere is really slim, because there are really deep-rooted reasons for these things to exist. As I said, the people that do this have been victim of this themselves, and you won't just argue them out of it. It's not with some rational arguments that you're going to solve this problem. They will have to look into their relationship with their parents that may be deceased, which makes it even more difficult. So don't get into a conflict over it, but realize that when you detect this and when it is directed towards you, that it has no real foundation in real life whatsoever. You already exist. You are a real, complete and existing person, independent of any condition you meet or will meet or have met. Your value as a being is completely independent of the conditions you will meet or have met or are meeting. You are already there, and it's very good as it is. It's okay, it's perfect. So let me know what your thoughts are about this in the comments. Check out the links to my books in my description too. A gigantic thank you to all those wonderful people who subscribe and like. You are really fabulous. Thank you so much. And see you next time.